Good morning, everyone. My name is Albert Cruz from SWR. So in this talk, I will present our work on the service robot that operates in uncertain and dynamic environment. This work is supported by NRCTO, and the team is on the hospital service robot. Yeah, so in as a brief introduction, in SWR, our vision is to develop service robot technology to solve smart nation challenges, especially in Singapore. So we are developing intelligent smart robots to perform autonomous tasks in dynamic and structured environment, collaborate or assist human as work as a team. So compared to those manufacturing robots, the robot here is prepared to meet the uncertainty in the real environment. That is the goal. And we also collaborate with government agencies and public sector where we develop a proof of concept prototype, and then the solution or the technology can be scaled for more testing and trial towards a product that can impact the industry productivity. So as you see in some of the pictures here, we have previous robots like working in library, and then we have the pasar patrolling robot, and we have the mobile manipulator work. So in this particular talk, I will discuss more on the hospital service robot. Next, please. Yeah, so the content is first we explain the motivation and the goal of this particular work. And then we'll present what we have prepared. Like in we have a simulation world with lift and system. This is a lightweight and will be free to use for training to understand different scenario how the robot will behave. Then we'll offer a solution for a problem with localization in dynamic environment. So this is an enhancement to the existing ROS package AMTL.
Sorry, Albertus, could you place the mic closer to your, to where you are speaking, because it's a bit soft from our side.
Oh, okay, let me try to...
Yeah, could you try putting closer to your to where you are speaking?
Okay, test. Is it better now?
Yep, it's better now. Thank you.
Test. Okay. Sorry for that. Okay, thanks for highlighting. Okay, so I carry on. In using the simulation world, we will also explain the experimentation, how to do a bedside delivery in the presence of disturbances. And then we'll show different scenario, like there is a obstacle, there is a curtain being closed, and there is a code blue being activated. And then we'll show the previous experimentation in a mock-up hospital work. And we go to shortly on the future works that we are doing now. Okay, let's proceed. Yeah, so we the motivation is to develop a medical assistive robot to help the nurse and doctor for item delivery in hospital. So current industrial solution, there are robots that can carry a large volume of goods. In some larger hospital, it was used to carry the goods from the kitchen to the front side of the ward. However, there are two problems here. One is the nurse is still required to bring the item from the large robot into the bedside, into the patient, to serve to the patient. And on other smaller hospitals, probably there is no existing route for such large robot to operate in the environment. So here we are developing service robot, relatively smaller in size, much more nimble, and we want the service robot to be able to understand emergency cases like code red, which is fire alarm, code blue is there is somebody require urgent attention, one of the bed require urgent attention. And then We want the robot to move inside the hospital ward, dynamic in the presence of people. So a lot of people, not all of them are engineers, they're mostly nurse or visitor or the family of the patient. We want the robot to be able to understand situation where it needs to give way to more important objects, for example, beds and also wheelchairs. So in this kind of situation, his priority is less compared to these objects, like maybe going to operating theater. And then we the robot, despite all the intelligence, we also understand robot has its own limitation, like the physical limitations such as the sensor field of view coverage, and then having limited understanding of the environment. So we also allow the robot to be pushed away, even manually, and then from there on, we add an ability for it to recover automatically after being disturbed. So we also add intelligence where the robot is able to determine appropriate place to approach the bedside. So sometimes there is a family, or there is an item, there is a moving table, or there is a cardiac table, or there is a doctor or nurse. So in this case, the robot is finding alternative approach to the bed in the presence of these uncertain obstacles. Yeah, we carry on. Okay. Here we are showing the two-level virtual world. It's quite lightweight compared to some of the other very complex world, and this is built using some tools that's available, like the cafe world. We are adding two things here. One is a lift, and the other is a plugin for a curtain. So here the curtain can be made to be open or half closed or fully closed. So this is the elevator. Yeah, we separate the floor location for easier visibility, and then there are curtains plugin. So this simulation will be made open. Carry on. Okay, this is example of a curtain that can be open and closed. You can click the video. So this simulates ad hoc. Sometimes the patient just don't want to be disturbed to close their own cubicle, or sometimes the nurse having a checkup or serving the patient, then the curtain can be closed. So these things are unscheduled and unpredicted to even to the RMS or to the command center. This is showing how the plugin works, so can easily alter online as the simulation goes. You can close it anytime and open it anytime. Okay, next. Can go next slide. Okay, next is we address this problem of localization in dynamic environment, especially when there is a large object altering the environment. So this is a typical way of localization. You can click, it's a video. So we have the simulation world in the left, and we have the map as made by GMapping in ROS. And in the and using MCL, the robot able to localize. However, when there are changes in the environment, it is possible that the localization convergence is compromised. The integrity of the localization is compromised, and the robot is drifted or having multiple probabilistic value where he actually is. So in this example, showing in the, this is the typical map. So for example, we give it a go. So in this case, in the early part, he has a very small convergence value seen at the as the cluster of red arrow just right in front of him. So those are sector of where he's going. And as he goes in between the curtain, this is what typically happens. He has two probabilistic value, uncertain value. This, if this happens in a prolonged period of time, this is considered a loss, a robot drift, and it is not easy to detect it. Next slide. The next slide, please. Right. So this is a solution that we offered. So this is how we increase in the presence of disturbance. In this case, the disturbance is uncertain, but it is predictable. The size and where it is predictable. So our solution is to have the AMCL packet able to make use of the projected location of the curtain. In this case, we made it into a gray color. The reason is with this gray scale, the path planner is still able to go across this gray boundary if required. In the same time, you as can be seen here, the convergence of the localization is still very strong because he makes use of the predictable drawing of the curtain in the map. So the alteration in the AMCL that we would like to offer is the additional grayscale drawings that is also used as an observation source. Okay, next slide. Okay, this is just a comparison of the two of the existing MCL and the modified MCL. So the solution is to draw the predictable large object. This could be curtain, doors, even partition. Sometimes there's some large environment where partition can be made, but it's predictable where it will be. We can also use it. Okay, next we move on to the going for the bait delivery mission. Oh, sorry, please stay in this slide. Okay, so in this slide, there we have four baits, bait 1, 2, 3, and 4. So what we did on the navigation is allow it to have alternative bait site approach. So there's always a priority site. For example, it's always nearer to the head site of the patient. So it's within unreach. The patient don't even have to move much. But however, if it is being blocked by other unknown object, robot is able to find alternative to the solution. For example, go from the other side or go from the foot side if there is no option. So this will be, we will show this soon. Go to the next slide. So in this is a picture of the robot mission. So we have developed a mission builder where the user can leverage on modules. It's almost like a state machine that can be pre-built and sent to the robot, so the robot knows what to do in the specific situation. So it looks complicated, but it actually consists of several parts. You can click. Okay, so first is he needs to fetch goods at the nurse station. So there are some navigational mission to go fetch goods. And at that site, the nurse can place the goods at the robot and then press continue for the robot to deliver. Okay, now it's a loop. So this is a bait one delivery loop. There are several branches here. The main branch is how the robot will execute when everything is according to plan. The robot able to approach and then complete the delivery. The patient takes the food and then press the continue button. However, there are some branches here. The branches include what happens if what the robot should do in the situation where he can't even approach the bait. So in this case, we made him wait. We made him find a nearby waiting area, and he can retry again after some time, and we make a loop where he can do this retry a few times before he finally give up. So basically it means this bait do not want to be disturbed, or the food cannot be served at the moment. So there are several, so it consists of several loops. If you click again, so there is bait 1 loop, bait 2 loop, bait 3, and bait 4. So all of this is made using a drag drop interface. No coding required, but you need to specify what is inside the module, what kind of navigation mechanism to execute. And the branches is the some part is leading to the next progression of the mission, and some part is showing exceptions, like he's unable to approach and all this is exception. And then from there, he executes what is written, what is being told here. And finally, he returned to the nurse station. So this is how the mission is built in our interface in our command center. This is a can go to the next slide. This is code view activation and repeated loop check. So this is another plugin in our interface where at any point of time during delivery, code blue can be activated or code red. In this situation, the order that we receive from the hospital procedure is to continue as per instructed, unless if the code blue is activated on the target bit. So if he's going to bit one and bit one code blue is suddenly activated, robot will decide to skip that bit and continue with the rest of the mission, if any. So that is this plugin just simulate this code blue activation. In the actual case, code blue button is located on the bit side, on the wall near the bit, and by right it is linked to the command, to the RMF system that can tell the robot there is a code blue being activated for that particular bit. Okay, next is the repeated loop check. So as mentioned, there is a handler of how many retry we want the robot to do before he decide to give up on a particular bit, because the bit is unapproachable. It's fully occupied or there's a lot of visitor nearby. So when this exceeded, he will cancel that delivery to the bit. Next. Okay, so this is the simulation experimentation for bedside delivery. You can click the video. Yeah, first he is at the nurse kitchen. He is fetching the item. Delivering, the mission is to deliver to each bed, 1, 2, 3, 4 in that order. So here, this is fast forward. Obviously, it doesn't move that fast. So the first example is there is no problem. We reach the head side. So in the second bit, we start to disturb him. We put a disturbance. We put a foreign object there, unknown to him. So when he tried to reach that priority side, he saw, okay, it's occupied. Then he'll plan an alternative approach to that bit, to bit two. In this case, it was near the lake side. So this alternative side. So here by right, the patient took it and pressed the button, continue button. Now he's going to bit 3. In bit 3, then we use the plugin to close the curtain to simulate don't want to be disturbed. So he checked priority side, and then he checked the other side. So both sides is locked. So here the robot will start to plan to wait. But he doesn't wait where he stands, because that may block other people. He tried to wait in an unoccupied site, some site that he thinks he can make it. So in this case, he will go wait near the wall. Okay, so here he realized all spot is blocked. He'll go to nearest available waiting spot. Okay, we just simulate this by waiting for a short while before he try again. So then suppose the patient open the curtain, then robot will try again to that bit. Okay, he's going to the priority site and he reached that bit. Yeah, so this is showing his resilience to always try again when the first time he failed. And for the last bit, we just show here is we actually activate the code blue. Well, he went to the bed 4. On the way to bed 4, code blue activated, he knows it, and then he just skipped that bit. Yeah, so that shows some possible scenario that was prepared in the mission. Yeah, so this is the future work that we are still in progress under NR2PO. We are in progress of, so here we have shown we are approaching bits and that is in a fixed position. However, as we do experiments, we realize that this is not always the case. There are situations where sometimes the bit has been moved in a few, maybe 1 meter away in a typical manner, or sometimes it could be further away, even further away. In this case, those typical A to B situation, robot from A going to B, will not work anymore because B has been made uncertain. So here we have to integrate with the perception how to we still able to approach arbitrarily move object and then still able to find alternate side, left side, right side, or other side. And then we are in progress of linking this extra intelligence with RMS. So that at the moment this is work in progress as there is no precedent of having this ability yet. And then a continuing test in CGH where we robot travel indoor and outdoor over a 300 meter route. And of course, we also in progress of upgrading to ROS 2. Okay, that concludes my presentation. Thank you. So this work is supported by NR2PO and yeah, we thank you for all the support.